Jesus said to the Jewish crowds, "I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and died, whoever eats this bread will live forever." The Gospel of the Lord. Today is the Feast of Corpus Christi, Latin for the Body of Christ, and we celebrate this meal. When I was a kid growing up, I absolutely hated and detested Sundays. We always had our main meal at noon, and it was a pot roast, which I loved. But then when everything got cleaned up and put away, we all got in the car and we went to the convent, because my mother had two sisters, Sister Anne Margaret and Sister Immaculata, who were semi-cloistered Benedictine nuns. And every Sunday afternoon, I had to sit for 2 hours at that convent. It was unmitigated torture. I'm 11, 12 years old. All my buddies are outside playing. And what do you talk to two semi-cloistered nuns about for 2 hours? I didn't realize it at the time, but it was child abuse, pure and simple. Some of you kids complain about coming to Mass. This is a piece of cake compared to what I had to sit through. And then, as if that wasn't bad enough, when we left the convent, we went to the German church for Tenebrae, and the whole thing was sung in German for a half hour. I didn't understand a word they were saying. But then after that, we went to my grandmother's house for supper, and everybody was there, aunts, uncles, cousins. There was food that wouldn't end. They made their own homemade beer, and each of us kids was given a little glass of beer to drink with the adults. And in the joy of that meal, you forgot all the torture of the rest of the day. And it's the same way when we come to this table to be fed. You come in here with your fears, your anxieties, your problems of life, and when you come to this table and are fed, nothing magic happens, but you're no longer alone. The Lord walks the journey with you. 100 years before the birth of Christ, God spoke to us through the prophet Sirach, and he said, "I created you, I have called you by name, and you are mine. Even if you walk through raging waters, you will not drown. If you step on burning coals, you will not be harmed. You are precious in my sight, and I love you. Be not afraid." And when we come to this table and are fed, that promise is fulfilled. And furthermore, everybody should come to this table. Jesus never denied his Eucharist to anyone, nor do we. Amen.